Welcome to Dormet Dining. I'm your host, Nicole Cormier, a registered dietitian, and here with me today is Shanika, a BSU student.
Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. So we are going to make homemade guacamole today from scratch. The only ingredients that are necessary, and you can definitely change this up to your preference, but you start off with at least 2 avocados. Then we're going to add some garlic, and you can either use the minced garlic or just simply buy a whole garlic cube bulb and dice it up really finely. We're going to add some lemon juice, tomato, diced tomato, and cilantro. You can either add the cilantro or you can leave the cilantro out. Cilantro is actually one of those herbs that some people are super tasters too. So some people, when they eat cilantro, they actually get a soapy taste in their mouth, and then others absolutely love it. Do you know if you like cilantro or
not? I've never had it, so.
We'll see today. So here's our ingredients. Instead of sour cream, we're going to actually use the Greek yogurt. It has the same consistency as sour cream, but it's going to add a lot more protein, so it's going to help fill us up a lot more.
Okay.
And then to dip our guacamole, we're going to use the Food Should Taste Good chips, which these are actually a local chip made in Needham Heights. And then you can see that there's 3 grams of fiber, so we know that a good source of fiber has to have at least 3 grams. And these have
3 grams, yep.
Great. And the other thing to keep in mind is that you can understand all of the ingredients. So when you're reading the ingredient list, you really should be able to know what's in your foods. Mm-hmm. And if you don't recognize something, that might be a red flag that there's a better option for that. Okay, so we'll start with getting our avocados ready. To slice an avocado, you just stand it straight up, cut straight down and around. There's a very large seed in the avocado. And so you'll just pop it open. So we want to remove this seed. And sometimes you can pop it out. Other times it might be a little bit trickier. So, oh, we got it. Okay. All right. And then to just take the avocado out, we're just going to scoop it and pop it right out into our bowl. And we're going to mix all of these ingredients together in one bowl. So it doesn't matter the order that we put them in. They're all going to get mashed. Okay, so we'll do, do you want to try the second one?
Yeah.
Okay, there you go. I'll remove this stuff for you. Avocados have the highest fiber content out of all fruit. So there is about 11 to 12 grams of fiber in one avocado. So it's very filling, very good for your digestive system to manage your blood sugars. Some of the seeds are a little bit trickier to get out, so if you don't feel comfortable using a knife, you can take a spoon and just kind of pop it out just like that. Avocados are also an extremely healthy source of fat, so in order to absorb vitamins A, D, E, and K, you need a good healthy fat source, specifically from a plant. So avocados are a great monounsaturated fat that will help you absorb all of those vitamins and minerals. Perfect. All right, we'll move this to the side. And our next ingredient, yep, we're gonna take our juice from a lemon. So I'll take 1/2, you can take the other. We'll just get the seeds out of it and then we can squeeze it right into, with a little squirts, right into the bowl. This one's probably just enough, so we can save that one for later. And then our next is our tomato. So our tomato is just going to be simply chopped. So to chop the tomato, I just like to take the top off, and then we can cut it. I'll let you do that half. And just keeping it flat on a surface is the easiest way to do a dice. So you can just cut it all in the same direction, and then flip it around the other way and do it cut it just the opposite direction. Okay, I'll let you do that one. Tomatoes are just coming in season, so if you attend to any of the farmers markets, or you'll notice in the grocery store that the tomatoes are getting a little bit richer in color, and that way they're going to be a little bit richer in flavor as well as they come into season. Perfect. You can add those to the bowl. Depending on how ripe your avocado is, ours aren't the ripest, so we're going to need to take a little bit more muscle to mash them. So I'm just going to actually remove the tomatoes just for the beginning until we get the right consistency we want from the actual avocados. To ripen your avocado, if you buy them in the grocery store and they're not exactly soft enough yet, you can put them in a brown paper bag, roll the paper bag up, and just leave it on the counter overnight, mm-hmm. and it will be nice and soft for you the next day. Okay. So we're gonna try to mash these up. I brought a knife in case, so if you wanna just, almost like you're cutting something on the dinner table, and just kind of keep going until you want to take over doing that.
Sure.
And while she's mashing up the avocado, I'm going to take the garlic and just start mincing a little bit of garlic. One.
Should I keep going?
Yep, just keep going at it. So we're trying to get them into the smallest pieces we can so we can start mashing it all together. Guacamole makes a really great snack. You're getting lots of fiber. And then you can also use it as a topping. So in a future show, we're going to be doing chickpea tacos, and that would be a great condiment to serve with any type of taco dish or burrito dish. You can make some guacamole and have it on the side, or add it into your taco. It's coming along.
Yeah.
So now that you kind of got it to that consistency, you can take like a strong spoon and kind of start trying to mash it up a little bit more.
Okay.
And then we'll add the garlic. So when you're chopping the garlic, you always want to make sure that you take the very tip off of it. We actually can't digest the little tip that you'll see. It's a little bit rougher. And if you just by chopping off the tip, you'll be able to digest it. By adding garlic to all of your recipes, you're getting a lot of health benefits. They're really good for your heart health, cholesterol levels, blood pressure. Okay, I'm gonna add the garlic. Oops. And then our last ingredient is the cilantro, and then the yogurt. So when you chop your cilantro, just kind of hold it into a bunch. Place it down on any cutting board and just chop. Just the tops until you get to the stem part. Okay. And just a tablespoon of either a sour cream or the Greek yogurt. This will make your guacamole a little bit more of a creamy consistency. And we'll add our tomatoes back in now.
So with the garlic, is it the same if you use garlic powder or you shouldn't use garlic powder?
You can definitely use garlic powder to get a really nice garlic flavor to it. By adding the fresh garlic and chopping it yourself, you're just getting more health benefits because it's okay. Coming from the whole food and it hasn't been processed yet.
Okay.
But if garlic powder is all that you have available, you can definitely make your guacamole like that. So for our finishing touch, we'll just add a little bit of salt and a little bit of pepper. And we can place it right here and we'll be all set. Can even a little bit of cilantro for the top for a garnish, and we're done.